Welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to Valentine's week, and we are nearly at the final stretch now. So one last cocktail, and tomorrow on the actual Valentine's Day, I'm gonna share another one just because I can. And why not? You never know. Maybe the last one is gonna be the one which you choose to drink. So get ready and let's crack on. Alright guys, today I'm gonna prepare for you the cocktail Dunderstruck. Alright? It doesn't sound very Valentine's name, but it's a wonderful cocktail, and since we had a cocktail with rum yesterday, but light rum, today we're gonna move a little bit higher and we're gonna hit the spot with a high proof rum. So I'm gonna use Rum Cologne, which is 111 proof. So this gives us 55.5% ABV. Not bad. It may sound so strong, but it's not. It's fantastic, smooth rum from El Salvador. So you're gonna love it. And if you can grab this rum, I strongly suggest you look for it and you put it on your shelf. All right? The cocktail is shaken. It's a wonderful red rich color and it's pairing fantastic ingredients. Apart from the rum, you have a little bit of Campari to bring some bitterness. Then you have a lovely strawberry syrup, which is bring this lovely fruity flavor to the cocktail. And finally, just the two dashes of anisette. Originally, the cocktail is made with absinthe, but I don't hold absinthe in my bar. It may change someday, but I find it out that after a long time making a cocktails, I don't use that much absinthe in order for me to go and purchase one. So I'm gonna use today's substitution. I'm gonna use Pernod, which is again anisette flavor. And we're using only two dashes. So it's not gonna make that much difference. It's just gonna bring this lovely, like a little bit refreshing anisette flavor in the cocktail. So let's start making it. So a proof rum, I'm using Rum Cologne, as I mentioned, 30 ml of your rum. And then we're gonna move to the Campari. So Campari, it's only a little bit, just of course, it needs to bring this bitterness. And I know some of you love Campari, some of you maybe not that big fan of the bitter, but trust me, mix it with a lovely strawberry and with the rum, it's absolutely amazing. And there's one more ingredient which you're gonna see, I didn't mention in the beginning. So, Campari, 22.5 ml of your Campari. So I don't know, you don't have to be so precise to be 22.5. You can easily go with 25 ml, or if you want less bitterness, you can drop 20 ml and that'll be absolutely just right, okay? Now, strawberry syrup. If you have strawberry syrups on your shelf or you buy already Monin or any other brand, use it. But if you wanna have a real crispy flavor, the real strawberry without the sugary feeling, but the feeling like you're eating a strawberry, make yourself a blended strawberry syrup. And if you didn't watch my short video, here is the card or link in the description, so you can see in 1 minute how to make fantastic blended strawberry syrup to preserve the freshness of the strawberry. So only 15 ml, and as you can see, because it's blended, it's almost like a puree. So I don't know why I'm calling it syrup, because it's really literally like a puree. But trust me, this is just, oh, my kids love it. They just sit there like that with a spoon. So, you know, I mean, you can use it for your pancakes, for breakfast, for waffles, for whatever you want, not just for cocktails. Okay? Now, the other ingredients which I didn't mention earlier, it's pineapple juice. Make sure you're using cold pressed pineapple, real pineapple, not from concentrate. So 45 ml of the pineapple, and you see where I'm going now, okay? We have a rum, we have pineapple. Absolutely tropical flavor. Then we bring the Campari for a bitterness and the strawberries for a sweetness. Beautiful summer drink, but still winter. However, we're not far away from the good weather. And finally, as I mentioned, the original recipe required 2 dashes of absinthe. I'm just gonna use my Pernod just to bring this anisette. And I'm gonna use bar spoon, but not full, just a little bit of the bar spoon. That's it. That'll be absolutely enough. And now we're gonna shake. feel like I'm speaking too fast today. I don't know why. I'm not rushing for anyway, okay? Not going anywhere, it's locked down. Nothing happening exciting, so let's drop some of the ice. I'm still having lots of ice left from making my clear ice, so nearly there using it, but give it a good shake. Wonderful. Oh yes, ice beautiful. So far, so good. Surfing old-fashioned glass over ice. I will use a clear ice, of course. It's not very clear now because it just came out of the freezer, but when I pour the drink, you'll see what I'm talking about. However, if you don't have a big chunk of ice, just fill up your glass with ice and that's it. And this is it. Look at that beautiful thing. Very lovely color. It's like a pink, between pink and peach color. It's amazing. It's absolutely fantastic. Right. I have to mention here that if you have Jamaican rum or overproof Jamaican rum, use it. It's happened to me to have just the El Salvador, so no big difference. You can use probably another rum, it doesn't need to be overproof, but just in case, if you're wondering, oh, how I'm gonna do that, don't worry about it. Garnish, a fresh strawberry, shaped kind of in the heart shape. I try my best. But there you go, that's your Dunder's truck, guys, so let's test it. Oh. On the nose you get these strawberries and the pineapple. It's absolutely amazing, and when you sip, first you hit the sweetness from the pineapple and from the strawberry, and then on the back end it's coming a very mild bitterness because the rum and the pineapple and the strawberry kind of overpower the bitterness, but you have this little touch of bitterness. And this final two dashes or a small drop of anise, it's make the whole difference. It's bringing the cocktail very light and very refreshing. It's a wonderful drink, trust me. Absolutely amazing. Thank you for watching, guys. Thank you for being with the channel. Thanks to all new subscribers and of course to old subscribers that are sticking around. I really appreciate it. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you're new, you know the drill. Subscribe if you desire. If not, thanks for stopping by. And of course, as always, stay safe and I'll see you tomorrow with my last video for Valentine's Week special. Until then, I love you and I leave you. Bye-bye.